Good evening. Welcome to worship. You know, we really don't breathe that strong, but you guys are good. You're good. Look at that. Y'all squeeze really nicely in one row, and then you got the young ones shafted upstairs. Is that how that works? That's really good. That's good. All right. You ladies, huh? So this is the women's side of the church. Is that how that works? All right. Hey, did we have a good day?
Yes.
Yes? That's great. Sunshine, warm. You think spring's coming? So with this daylight savings, does that mean it goes back to being darker in the morning but longer nights? Yeah. Meaning sunner, like daytime more? But in a week from now, what happens? So it's going to be like I can wake up in the morning and it's no longer going to be bright out at 5:36? Thank goodness. Yes, that's great. Excellent. Well, welcome to worship today. We have one of my favorite chapters in the Bible. It's Luke 15. Can anybody tell me right off the bat, unless you've been cheating and looking at the bulletin? It's the lost and found chapter. Okay? Have you guys ever lost anything? You go to the lost and found box and you got it? That's exciting when that happens, especially when it's something you really missed. It's kind of like that, but even a much bigger deal. So whether it's a lost coin or have you ever lost any money? There was one time I was walking down the street in my childhood area and I found a $20 bill back in the day when people had cash and it was always floating around. And I found 20, and as a kid, I was like, oh, that's big time money, okay? So I'm like telling everybody about it and everything, and it's just like my friend, who I had a crush on, his older sister, said, he said, well, my sister was walking down that street and she said she lost a $20 bill. And I just had to trust them. And I gave it back, probably because I had a crush on her. I don't know, but yeah. Okay, let's prepare our hearts now for the diminishing lights. Remember, we light things up during the Christmas season. Increase the lights each Sunday. Well, now, as we prepare for Good Friday, and we extinguish a candle each weekend to remind us of the approaching darkness of Jesus' betrayal and death. So during this time of Lenten preparation, we think of those who turned away from the light of Jesus. And we remember that we too turn away. We will never know the motivations of Judas's betrayal. All we know is that Judas thought his agenda was more important than Jesus. We too are all often willing to put our agenda and priorities ahead of the light of the world. We extinguish this third candle, recalling with regret the times we have betrayed Jesus by the darkness of our own self-centered willfulness. So today we're going to talk, one of the greatest parables of all time is the parable of the lost son, or loving father, as it has been told. And so what I love about that is, even as we may go on our way separate from God or separate from the loving father, God always welcomes us home, and whatever binds us from fully living life to the fullest, God can set our chains free. So let's sing, really based on the song Amazing Grace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Taught my heart to fear.
has promised good to me. His word, my hope, secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as I. God, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains unending love. Shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine, but God, who called me here below, will be.
Oh Lord, we are grateful, grateful to you for the life you've given us, for the fresh air and the air that we breathe, that we have breath, the breath of life. We thank you, Lord, for the sunshine. We thank you for those who walk with us in this life, on this earth. We thank you for those gathered in this space and those gathered online, that we can do life together. Various ways. We thank you for those who came out to the woods and helped with the maple syruping. Lord, we also know that we come with stories, stories intertwined with gladness and sadness, with grief and with joy. And Lord, sometimes we feel distant, disconnected. Maybe even sometimes when we feel we don't even belong. But Lord, you call us home. You are like that loving Father with open arms, ready to take us home at any time. And so Lord, we come to you now, knowing those arms are open and your ears are listening, listening to your children praying. So Lord, we share whatever is on our mind or heart right now in the silence of our hearts. God, your grace is amazing. What you did for us, Jesus, to show us the way, the truth, and the life, for you to die on the cross for our sins, for the disciples who betrayed you, for those who walked away, for those who hid, for all of us who have not proclaimed your name, who've walked away in our various ways. Lord, you still went to the cross for us so that our sins may be forgiven,
So in Jesus' name, you declare you are forgiven. People of God, brothers and sisters in Christ, you are forgiven. Your chains are gone. You've been set free. Now live in that boldly, standing up tall, being connected to God and being connected to these brothers and sisters in Christ. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll continue with ancient words, even though it's not in the bulletin. We do an audible, especially when Clara says, hey, we're going to do ancient words. Of course we will. Be seated for the reading of the scripture.
So Luke 15, known for those parables of lost and found. And it's amazing because this whole section starts off with a very key situation. You've got some people gathered, and it's a very unusual group. Okay? So listen carefully to who is gathered and what's going on in these dynamics. So let's begin with Luke 15, starting with verse 1. Now all the tax collectors and sinners were coming near to listen to Jesus. And the Pharisees and the scribes were grumbling and saying, "This fellow welcomes sinners and eats with them." So Jesus told them this parable. "Which one of you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness to go after the one that is lost until he finds it? When he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders and rejoices. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that was lost.' Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance." He's speaking this to the Pharisees, right? He's telling them, And then he goes on. Or what woman having 10 silver coins? What's silver going at right now? 27, 28 bucks? Okay. If she loses one of them, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it. When she has found it, she calls together her friends and neighbors, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the coin that I had lost." Just so I tell you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. Then Jesus said, "There's a man who had two sons. The younger of them said to his father, 'Father, give me the share of the property that will belong to me.' So he divided his property between them. A few days later, the younger son gathered all he had and traveled to a distant country. And there he squandered his property, resources, inheritance, and dissolute living. And when he had spent everything, a severe famine took place throughout that country, and he began to be in need. So when he went and hired himself out to the citizens of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed the pigs, so he would gladly have filled himself with the pods that the pigs were eating, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, 'How many of my father's hired hands have bread enough and to spare? But here I am dying of hunger. I will get up and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me like one of your hired hands.' So he set off and went to his father. But while he was still far off, his father saw him and he was filled with compassion. He ran and put his arms around him and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his slaves, 'Quickly, bring out a robe, the best one, and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. And get the fatted calf and kill it. Let us eat and celebrate, for this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.' And they began to celebrate. Now his older son was in the field, and when he came and approached the house, he heard music and dancing. He called one of the slaves and asked, 'Well, what's going on?' He replied, 'Well, your brother has come, and your father has killed the fatted calf because, well, he has got him safe back and sound, you know, back safe and sound.' Then he became angry, and he refused to go in. His father came out and began to plead with him, but he answered his father, 'Listen, for all these words, all these years, I have been working like a slave for you, and I have never disobeyed your command. Yet you have never given me even a young goat so that I may celebrate with my friends. And when this son of yours comes back, who has devoured your inheritance with prostitutes, you killed the fatted calf for him?' Then the father said to him, 'Son, son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. But we had to celebrate and rejoice, because this brother of yours was dead and has come to life. He was lost and has been found.'" Gospel of Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God. Who are the outcasts you knew or know now? I look at these. Some of these I recognize more than others. The Breakfast Club was totally vintage my era, okay? And there you can see various, I mean, you can call them out. You know, you got the jock, you got, you know, there's various names for each of them, right? And some groups were in and some groups were not. And some individuals were in and others just had nobody. Sounds like a strange question when you ask, who are the outcasts you knew or know now? It's even derogatory. I mean, oftentimes those who feel left out, lonely, disconnected, or rejected feel They don't belong. They may do certain things to try to fit in, even if it's against their moral values. Or they may just isolate themselves to the point of absolute loneliness, depression, and despair. If bullied, it can lead to devastating consequences. There's a short movie that left a huge impact on me when I was younger. It's called Cipher in the Snow. Anybody ever seen that? And I don't remember when I watched it. I want to say it was grade school, unless it was junior high. 23-minute movie. It's online, YouTube. It gave me a great compassion for my peers who didn't seem to fit in or connect with anybody. It helped me understand that their life at home may have been sad. It was painful for me to watch their lonely life in school, middle school or high school, as they sat alone at the lunch table, didn't interact with anybody in school unless they were bullied, and literally looked like they had nothing to look forward to. I want you to feel this, okay? Here's the beginning, but again, I suggest you watch this so that it can truly tug at your heartstrings. Let's go back. This is back in like the 70s or something. If you're homeschooled, you don't know what this is like.
Me on the shoulder, kind of apologetic like, and asked if he could get off, so I let him.
What's the matter with him?
He's dead, isn't he?
Better call an ambulance.
He had no friends. When he was talked to, he was always shamed, talked to harshly. He was always on his own, and every single thing was a difficult situation for him, because nobody talked to him. Have you ever felt lost? Like you just don't know where you are going in life? It could be that you are a young person, maybe in their teens or 20s, trying to figure out what God is calling you to do in life. Like, what vocation, what to study, what to be trained for. It could be that some health or other changes derailed your plans, and now you say to yourself, now what do I do? Or could you be like the prodigal son, just wanting his inheritance, taking it and running, only to find yourself left with nothing but pea pods and pig slop? Deeper yet, you could be contemplating, why in the world am I here on this earth? Or from a faith perspective, where is God leading me next? Those are signs of being lost. Imagine losing your companion for life. They died. Or you went through a divorce and you say to yourself, now what, God? Or you are simply a child who is trying to fit in, to be liked, and you'll compromise anything and everything just to belong. It can be a really lonely world out there. And to feel lost on top of it, well, that can be really despairing and scary. I want you to hear this today. God is running after you, pursuing you, seeking you, and finding you, even in the dark places where you hide or run away, because that's what loving fathers do. They care so much for their children that they are willing to do whatever it takes to reach their child, no matter how much harm to others or to themselves they have done. Our God, our Heavenly Father, never gives up. Never gives up looking for you and for me and trying to meet you where you are in life. Imagine being a young child playing hide-and-go-seek with one of your parents and the laughter and joy when you are found by that parent. Whether it's a lost sheep, a lost coin, or a lost son, there is such joy and laughter even when the lost is found. Our passage started with its first sentences about Jesus eating with outcasts, tax collectors, and sinners. Truly, the lost are rejected in society. Most lacking faith because, well, they were disposed of by their community. They were not welcome. They did not belong. But it was precisely what Jesus constantly did, right? He constantly reached out and he hung out with the outcasts. The sinners and the tax collectors, the ones that the Pharisees and others wrote off, because if the Pharisees said you can do that, well, others did as well. And Jesus loved them. He cared for them. He healed them, laughed and played and ate with them. Fellowship. No, if he saw you in the lunchroom at school, he'd be hanging out. That's the kind of Messiah and God we have. He's the one, like Jesus here in this series called The Chosen, who welcomes Peter as a disciple after he confesses he is not worthy. So whether you are online with us right now or present in this room, hear this clearly. You belong to God. God has not given up on you, but rather is looking and searching and seeking to reach you even as you hide or turn away. Secondly, you belong to this body of Christ, meaning the church. And our church is called St. Olaf. You belong to us if you want to be a part of us. We will not walk by you, but we will walk with you. We will not give up on you. You belong. You are loved by God and us. Let us pray. Loving Father, you who gives us the freedom to run away, to in a sense take our inheritance and run, but you always welcome us home with open arms, with laughter, a party, and hope. Draw those of us who have walked away from you for a time, that we may know your amazing love found in Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. There's a song I learned by a friend of mine, and if Madeline, I don't know if you were there, if Sam was here, but it was on a quake, and it goes like this. I'm going to do it a cappella, and you can see the words. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father God. Try that. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father God. One more time as a prayer. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father. Abba, we belong to you. We belong to you. Abba, Father God. You're our Abba, Father God. So we belong to God. And what God says to us, you are mine. Let's sing that beautiful hymn by David Haas. Please stand as you are able.
Afraid I am with you. I have Thankful for all the ways that God blesses our lives, we share those blessings with others through the ministries here at St. Olaf. Your offering plays an important part in our ability to serve others. We offer a number of options to give in this time, either online with your phone or computer, or by dropping off or mailing to our church. You can find more information on our website.
Join me with saying the Apostles' Creed.
I believe
in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We are found in you, Lord. Let us share your love with others, praying for the church, the world, and all in need. Lord, many go through life giving little thought to faith, too busy, distracted by the here and now, only spurred to faith by tragedy or hitting a major low. Find us, Lord, as we wander aimlessly. Give our life a deeper meaning. Fill us with pure joy in knowing you. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Bring knowledge and understanding to leaders in our nation. Be present in their decisions during this time of turmoil. Encourage talks of peace among nations around the globe. Resolve conflicts and tensions between opposing sides. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. So much is beyond our control, Lord. Winds and waves, earthquakes, the heat of summer, the cold of winter, health conditions, the economy, other drivers on the road, the list goes on. Help us to focus on you and on our own actions, on our relationships with others. Calmed by knowing that you've got the rest, hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Please join me in praying for these friends and family of our congregation. Noah,
Harriet, Jenna, Ken, Herb Heck, Tom Christofferson, Marlene, Kathy L.
And we ask also include Jody Wells. And we also pray for those serving in the military around the globe and those who have returned home. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Help us, Lord, to be more accepting of others. We have bias and prejudice towards others and the situation they are in. None is without fault. We all have gone astray. Let us be compassionate and show your love to all. In your eyes, we are no better than any of your children. We have all sinned. We are all in need of attention, love, and someone to listen. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Abba, Father, we belong to you. Please keep watch over our lives. Hear us in your prayer. In your Son, Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. So if you've watched the video clips of The Chosen, if you haven't checked that out, just Google that. But in any case, what you'll learn is Jesus did not call the top A students. These were not the cream of the crop, because normally they would have been picked up by now. So they were kind of like, well, it looks like we're going fishing. And some of these guys, like one is Matthew the tax collector, and he was He was a total social outcast. He had no friends. He was making some serious coin, but he had a lot of issues, if you look at the movie Chosen. In any case, Jesus still called him by name. You are mine. And as they traveled through 3 years together, grew close to one another, they still got to the point where a few of them, you know, one betrays, one denies, another, you know, a bunch of them just say, well, oh my gosh, he's going to the cross, I'm out of here. And yet Jesus breaks bread with them and says, after giving thanks, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Following that supper, he took a cup, he gave thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Again, do this, remember me. Let us join the prayer he taught disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. And if you're at home with us, if you have bread or wine or grape juice, you can feel free to pull that out. Maybe you have that handy already. As we do here, we take the thin film off the top. This is the body of Christ given for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Oh, do we have stuff going on here? It's just way too exciting. For 15 years, I was with somebody in the woods, and he was telling me, yeah, I was on that committee 15 years ago when they were talking about some sign. And we kept putting it off, and there's some funds, but never happened. Well, hey, guess what, folks? It sounds like it's happening. Tomorrow, 10 a.m., if you're just flipping the remote, crawling out of bed or whatever, you are welcome here, or you can still have your jammies on and come on Zoom for our little meeting, okay? And we'll discuss the sign that's going to shine in lights. And we're going to discuss the patio that's going to be welcoming and inviting to our neighbors, right? So if you want to have some input, hear more about that, 10 a.m. tomorrow. Anything else we need to highlight? Lots of people out in the forest. Man, we got that done an hour and a half, and we just tap, tap, tapped all day long. Anything else? Nobody standing, nobody. All right. Well, then let's sing You Never Let Go. Oh, yeah, you can stand. That's, yeah. Or you can sit, either way.
Never let go, Lord, you never let go.
life beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me.
Peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.